We brought educators together to discuss their experiences with implementing assistive technologies in the classroom. In this segment, they're talking about professional development.
What level of expertise does a classroom teacher need to have around assistive technology to meet the needs of students using laptops in the classroom?
I'm not sure if expertise is necessarily as important as a willingness to have the technology in your classroom and a willingness to learn yourself. If the student knows more than you, that's great because they can help you along with it. But as long as you're open and receptive to having the technology in your room, it doesn't matter what level you start at. You will become an expert throughout the year.
Teaching in a congregated class or even just in a regular classroom per se, using assistive technology provides opportunities for problem solving. You know, sometimes just things happen. And you can, you know, as an educator, you can demonstrate that to your students. And they can also, the learners themselves can show that to their colleagues as well. And I think by extension, there's also opportunities for self-advocacy. But definite problem solving, from the smallest thing to, you know, not having a USB stick to an outlet to, you know, the application has just quit, I haven't saved my work. So lots of avenues for demonstrating those learning skills.
I think as an administrator, I'm looking for teachers who are willing to take risks and to be able to go out there and literally make some mistakes in terms of some of the decisions that they made, but be able to recognize it, rebound, and learn from it. And in a lot of ways, the assistive technology is like a pioneer, and the teachers are the explorers and pioneers who are trying to use the technology to meet their kids' needs. And we're not always going to follow the right path. Sometimes we have to turn around, come back, and sometimes the kids will be leading us.
Is there any professional development opportunities available for teachers? It seems like quite a bit to learn. So is there anything out there?
More and more we're seeing access to professional development with this as a technology. The universities are now offering courses. Within boards, certainly at our board, for example, we have Where It's At ET. And so every Wednesday, the assistive technology consultant puts on a workshop and for anyone, and you can go there for an hour and a half after your school day and goes through, you know, you bring your laptop and you're able to work through the programs and learn the programs, bring them back to your school. You can teach everyone else in your school if that's possible. We also have a great website, a support website for AT.
In addition to that, we'd like to see students actually become the experts and in some cases train and work with teachers because, I mean, really that's what we want.
I know initially when I found out I was going to be getting technology in my classroom, I went to a video website, YouTube, and I typed in whatever I was using, and there's tons of free, like, 3-minute clips of different things you can learn without having to do anything formal. So from your living room, you can take a look and very quickly see what other teachers are doing with the technology already in their classroom.
Thank you.
In order to be able to provide the support to teachers, we were able to go to our principal, and she was able to help us out in directing us to where we could actually apply to the board for specific funds, and we were able to also access some funding in our school through the Student Success Initiative. And in that, we were able to then release teachers to be able to work directly with them.
Once the student develops that sort of basic competency and comfort level with those applications and the assistive technology, they're well positioned not only to instruct peers, possibly staff, but also younger students as well. And whether or not you have younger primary students coming into like a congregated class like mine with the interactive whiteboard and having some sort of peer teaching going on, that also develops their self-confidence and self-worth.
I think, again, as a school administrator, having assistive technology as part of a professional development day, being able to access board resources in terms of technicians who can come in and do demonstrations, I think what we find at our school is that the word spreads very quickly in terms of what's working and what's not. We'd also like to look at assistive technology really as just one piece of a teacher's professional development, but one that's not isolated, that is actually integrated into their approach of working with students and student achievement and reporting and evaluation, not in isolation. Teaching is a team sport.
Thanks for watching. You may wish to look at the other videos in this series and browse through the resources available on our website.